is to be what? Sober. Sober. So when you smoke marijuana, are you sober? Read it again. Titus chapter 2, verse 2. But the aged men be sober. So, in order for us to be the greatest people on earth, in order for us to get back to our Godship, to be the kings and the priests of the earth, we have to what? We have to be sober. Right? That's part of repentance, is putting that away.
Right.
Why would you want to live on the bottom when God created you to be up top?
Right.
Why is that? Why do we have so much low self-esteem that we gotta resort to smoking weed?
We gotta
resort to cocaine. We gotta resort to over-excessively drinking.
Right.
You understand? How do we get like that? How do we change? This is how we change. We did it. If we could do it, you could do it.
Right.
Read that again. Titus chapter 2, verse 2. That the aged men be sober, grave, temperate, sound in faith. So sound in faith, temperate, right? So if you're sound in faith and temperate, right, that means that you have control of yourself, right?
Right?
A lot of our people get into drugs because they have what? They lost control of their living situation. So why do you smoke it? How did you get into the habit of what? Want to do drugs? How did that happen?
Go ahead, y'all good. Y'all got a flyer?
What do you mean by that? But they disowned you. They're involved.
Damn, did it go off?
So it was something that they taught you.
Yeah.
Right? Read Titus 3 and 3.
One more time. Titus
3. The book of Titus, chapter 3, verse 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish. So we ourselves were once sometimes foolish. We went through the exact same thing. I used to indulge in it. Why? Because of my family. But like I said before, bro, if I could change, you can.
That's right.
You have to make that choice. Give me Psalms 119, verse 59.
Bring it out.
Because now that you know that, hey, look, you are an Israelite, that you have to change, because if you don't, you're going to get put to death.
Right.
Because now what? We gave you the light. We giving you the laws. So you either have to turn around or else. And you're not supposed to what? Wait till tomorrow. Wait till later on. You're supposed to do it right now.
Right.
Read it. Psalms. Chapter 119, verse 59.
Read.
I thought on my ways. So when I heard these laws, when I heard, like, you know what? I'm a king. I'm a God on this earth. I'm God's chosen special people. I'm holy, set apart from everyone else. I thought on my ways. I'm like, damn, I'm out here living like a nigga. I gotta stop. I'm not supposed to be doing drugs. I'm not supposed to be running to weed. That's what weak men do.
Right.
I'm not a weak man. I'm a king. I'm a God.
That's
so
right.
I thought on my ways. We don't. I thought on my ways and turned my feet. So when you turn your feet, what do you do? If you're going in this direction, when you turn your feet, what does that mean? You're going the other direction. I mean, you're not smoking that marijuana no more. You're not using that as a cop-out. Because, hey, you know what? My family did it. My dad did it. Well, because I'm stressed out. I ain't got no money. So what? God could change all that. Because it's hard out here. We understand that. We understand that it's rough out here for us. We on the bottom. But we are the example. This brother is an example.
Yes,
I am. The brothers you see, we down the street, we all over this country. We all over this world doing the exact same thing today. Because we are the example. If we can do it, you can do it. Read that. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3. Thou therefore endure hardness. You got to endure hardness. It's hard out here. You have to endure hardness. As what? As a good soldier. As a good soldier, because this is an army of God that he's raising up. Do you want to be part of this army? Are you fit for battle? Do you want to be fit for battle? Do you have a flyer? Make sure you give us a call. Come deal with us. We can help you get your mind right. But you have to make that first step. You have to make haste. You have to turn your feet and start keeping God's law. Then we can work with you. You know. A good soldier of Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. So, we're not supposed to be entangled into the affairs of his life, such as smoking weed, being whoremongers, being homosexuals, being in politics. Those are the affairs of this life that we're not supposed to be entangled with. We're supposed to keep thus saith the Lord. You understand that? And get ready for his second coming. Because it is coming. All you gotta do is turn on the news. All you gotta do is see the wickedness that is increasing in our people. We're losing consciousness even more and more. We're killing each other and celebrating. Making songs about it. Making weed about it. Those things aren't so. We're not supposed to hate each other like that.
You understand that? Go back to Acts 3:19.
The book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted.
So you have to repent and be converted. You have to change, bro. You have to stop doing those things. You must do it. Don't get put down. You know who you are according to the Bible, bro? You're an Israelite. Stick around, bro. Listen, read on.
Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out.
So you know what sins is according to the Bible? What is sin?
Anything that's against?
We're going to let the Bible speak so you can clearly understand on how to repent. Because there's no point in you repenting if you don't know what you need to repent from. Read that.
1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
So sin is breaking of the law. So you have to repent so your sins can be blotted out. Blotted out means to be erased. In order for you, for your sins to be blotted out and erased, you have to repent. You got to turn from not breaking. You understand that? So there's a process in repentance. There's a process, and I'm going to help you with that process. Because you're going to give us a call. I know you is. I know you're going to give us a call. You want to get your life cleaned up. Because, like I said, we did it, you could do it. It's easy. Wait.
Verse 46. If they sin against thee.
So if we sin against God, read.
For there is no man that sinneth not, and thou be angry with them.
Because God is angry with us. That's why we get shot down on the street. That's why we in the ghettos right now. That's why the weakest man on earth is ruling over us right now. The so-called white man is the weakest, the basis of all men. He's ruling over the strongest men on earth. How so? Because God is making that happen. Read on.
And deliver them to the enemy, so that they carry them away captives unto the land of the enemy.
So he in the land of our enemy. Why? Because he took this land over with the sword, with diseases. You understand that? The enemy took over this land, and now we are captives in this land.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.